Hey, I am Jelle, and you know what's super hip these days? Virtual production. You can be wherever you want, in Paris, New York, or even in space. But making movies like this is a lot of work afterwards. You have to do so much compositing to make it work. And after all that work, it still looks kind of fake. Is it because I'm using a bed sheet as green screen? No. It's the lighting. Look at this boring yellow light. This can't possibly light me in the correct manner. The new kit on the block is definitely those giant LED volumes. It's just like as if you were really there, but that giant volume is not gonna fit in my room. So let me just focus on the lighting part, and I can use my iPad and make like a virtual scene and cut me out with some AR magic or something. That I'll figure it out later. But for that, I'm going to need a better lamp. To the drawing board. If I want to get some even lighting, I'm going to need a very big area. Or a ring. Like all those fancy YouTubers use to vlog, and you can see these tiny rings in their eyes. But then like above my head. Like a little angel. I made a 1D game a few... 6 months ago? Man, I really need to make some more videos. Anyway, so I made this RGB ring lights that I can control with the microcontroller, and sent instructions from my game right to the lamp. Basically, I'm already done, right? Just hang it up and it will look good, right? No, it doesn't. I saw a fancy ceiling light once on the architecture biennale in Venice, and I really liked its design, so I'm just going to rip it off, place it in my room. I'm going to make it like a square donut with three pieces of aluminum and an acrylic cover, because I don't have a welding machine laying around, and knowing me, I'm probably going to want to take it apart again. I'm going to need some bolts and brackets, or like a lot of bolts and brackets. Yeah, they just keep coming. Now that I knew the dimensions of the bolts and brackets, I drew the design in CAD, because there's no way that I'm going to start drilling all those holes by hand. Off to the laser!
4 to 6 days later.
Alright, it should be done any minute now. Just a little bit.
4 to 6 more days later.
Little bit more.
1 semester later.
My parts are finally here. Look at that beautiful aluminum and its precisely cut holes. Wait a minute. I'm missing half of the holes. Where did they go? Oh no, why didn't they close? Oh my god. Alright, let's grab the drill. Now that I finally have all the holes I need, I can start putting the lamp together. Wait, I should probably think about how I'm going to mount it first. This might not be as straightforward as I thought. Anyone here to help me? Hello? Hello? Aha, I have an idea. Let's make some helping hands. Alright, number one, let's go. You can go up. And then there's number two. Just hold on to the ceiling. Okay, you're doing good. Let me just pull this one a little back. Oh no! Oh my god. Okay. Back to the other one. Okay. I need a little bit more tape. Okay. And now just pull it up. Okay. Final step. I can just drag. Yeah, shove it a little bit more. Yes, it's holding. Now that I know where the holes need to be, I better start drilling. That's a lot of dust. With the floor clean again, I can give the walls a quick black paint job to get a glassy look and start putting my lamp together. Alright, let's start bolting my 400 bolts. One, and then the two, and then the three. Let's keep going. And we're done. Thanks for watching that long montage of me bolting those brackets. If it were me, I would have just skipped it. I put the RGB strip on the outside and the white strip on the inside. So the RGB will illuminate me in the center, and I can use the white strip to light my room, because you know, my lamp is gone. I also made sure to alternate seams of the aluminum between the inside and the outside to give it some extra rigidity, because different parts aren't actually held together all that strong. Alright, let's see if the lamp works. Yes! Oh my god, I didn't make any terrible mistake up until now. But how am I actually going to control the lights? I'm not going to be manually changing the wires every time I want a different color. Well, let me explain. While wiring this up, I had a few things to worry about. To start, the white strips run on 24 volts, while the RGB strip runs at 5 volts, and the Arduino runs on 3.2 volts. That's why I got this voltage converter, to convert the incoming 24 volts from the power supply to 5 volts. I have two separate circuits running on the top and the bottom. Controlling the RGB strip with the Arduino is pretty simple. You just need to send a signal instruction to the strip and power it. The white one is a little bit more complicated, because you can't just send the signal directly to the strip. The voltage is way too high. Everything will just explode. At least, that's what I think. That's why you need these MOSFETs. They can control high voltage circuits with a low voltage signal. When everything works together, the Arduino can control both the RGB and the white LED strips from the power coming from the wall socket. Look how my whole setup perfectly fits in the lamp. It's like it's designed for it. To control the lamp, I use the web server capabilities of the Arduino to set up a little website so I can control my lamp from wherever I want. Because the Arduino has very little memory, I used as much existing libraries as possible to keep the code kind of short, and then store the page as a big string on the Arduino, ready to spit it out if it gets a request. Now let's get this lamp off the ground and onto the ceiling. Demo time!
Oh boy, it's very dark in here. Let's see if I can fix this. What is this? We have light? You know, controlling light with your phone is fun. But knowing I can control it with Wi-Fi gives it so much more possibilities. Like, I can even control it from all the way down here. Light on. And what if I wanted a different mood? Like red. This might send off the wrong vibes. Anyway.
Right, where was I? Oh yeah, the virtual production setup. A cool feature that I can use for that is people occlusion with my iPad. It's mostly used to hide the AR objects behind someone as they pass by. But as we keep making the object bigger, there is hardly any real world left. Just you and the endless virtual world. Or a virtual green screen. Look at me all green. Wait, that kind of defeats the whole point. Now I'm going to look green everywhere. I just need to show my virtual environment directly in real time on the iPad. Now, if I match the lighting to the virtual sky, there is no way anyone would notice that I'm not actually there. Luckily, I made an easy to use API so I can easily send my color from my iPad to my lamp. Now all I need is some cool environments, like a beautiful grassy field, or a sprawling busy city, or like a terrifying volcano. Let's put this virtual production rig to the test.
Hello fans, welcome to my vlog. Today I'm going to show you around the big city that I live in. Whoa, there's skyscrapers? Unbelievable! What kind of cool city am I in? Well, enough of the city. Let me show you around the beautiful parks that are also in the city. For whatever reason. Let me just please. Wow. What a beautiful forest this is. Unbelievable. I'm so lucky that I can be in here. But you know guys, I have one more special place we can go today. My local volcano, of course. Where is it? Where? Oh, there. Wow, that volcano sure does look very dangerous. Luckily, we're still at a very safe distance. We went from the city to the forest all the way to this volcano. What more can you ask from a day? I'll see you guys next time.
Thanks for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video and subscribe to see what I'm going to make next time. I promise you it's going to be something very cool. Bye.